What, like, medals and, like, awards did you earn when you served?
Yeah, I got the Combat Infantry Badge, I got 2 Purple Hearts, I got a Bronze Star. The French government gave me the Legion of Honor, their country's highest award. And the European Theater of Operations was 4 Bronze Stars, which is all I could get because there was only 4 major campaigns in Europe, Normandy, Northern France, Central Europe, and Germany. And I was in all of them, which is unusual for a frontline guy. And you get some other things. We got a unit citation for the Battle of Hickman Forest. I stayed in New York after the war because I grew up in New York State, then they called me and awarded me a war.
Like Bud Sprung, like I read how he was like kind of the leader about like a couple like veterans organizations. How would you like describe like the sense of community around being
in the service? The only one I know he was a member of was the FW. I don't think he belonged to the Legion. I'm not sure. I don't really know what others he belonged because he devoted most of his time to the VFW. In reality, he was a long-term member. He was commander for 17 years. He was a couple other officers before that, but as I recollect, he was not a really what you call a life member. Well, he was a life member, but he was not a. And he did a lot of work around the community because of the VFW, like Veterans Day, Fourth of July, Memorial Day, stuff like that. He was very active in all that stuff. And of course, he was on the program here at the school where honoring the students who were going in the military. And his wife was president of the ladies' auxiliary. We had a ladies' auxiliary. Now it's just an auxiliary because Mecca Blanca, too. His wife was president of that, and so they were to contain them with them. And he did hospital visits for a while and stuff like that. He did a wonderful job as commander. Our post probably wouldn't be where he is today without Bud Spring. And he took over, we had a mortgage, and over the years we had to add on to our property. And he really did a marvelous job as a commander.
Now, how many people are part of like that organization?
Oh, I think it's about 250. The Legion is larger than because they're. See, this is the difference between the Legion and the Legion. One guy asked that question the other day, what's the difference between the Legion and America or VFW? So, well, the Legion, you had to serve basically in certain times, but the terms were broader. VFW had to serve in a war zone at a time of crisis, not so you had to be there when there was risk. So you eliminate a lot of people in your life. Like in World War II, of the 16.2 million, I don't know, maybe three men of them after I really got very far overseas, 4 men, less than half, maybe a quarter of them got overseas or something. But they're all important. I don't mean anything less than, because you have to have support. That they have people support you. Like me, I get over, somebody had to get me over there on a boat, and they had to make first food, and there's a tremendous amount of people supporting you that you can go.
What advice would you give to someone who's like interested in going into the service?
I'd give them the same advice I would give you as a student at the school, or I'd give my children, I'd give my grandchildren, and I'd do it repeatedly. Whatever you do in this world, do your best and never give up. I don't care if you're up there cutting the grass for your parents. It doesn't take any longer to do a good job and a bad job. So why not always do the best? It's like coming to school. Do your best. I have a large family. My daughter was an A student. My oldest son was a C student. I expected her to get A's. I didn't expect him to get more than he could do, but I expected him to get what he could do. You should always do your best and never give up and respect others. If you do those things, you'll have a pretty happy life and be very successful. I came from a very modest, in fact, in my graduating class, I wasn't the poorest kid in the class. I was in the bottom group. I never went to college after where I could have. It was GI Bill. It was my choice. I'm glad it's this choice. And from that modest beginning, I rose up to being president and CEO of a multi-million-dollar company. Didn't retire until I was 80. But I don't think I ever cheated anybody in my work. In fact, when I retired, they spoke up and said, "Oh, see, he always gave you a full day." Because if you're going to be there, why not do it? I see people go, they can't wait to finally go to the restroom or something to get out of the way, so I have to goof off. You still got to be there. Why not do your best? I think I always did my best. I'm active with the veterans organizations. I'm not just an officer. I get involved. I try to do things. Because if you're going to do something, why not do your best? Always do your best. And when I speak at colleges, I can encourage kids not to be late. Don't cut classes. That's part of doing your best.